All right, so if you guys just want to click accept, we'll get right into the presentation. Cool, so I'm going to share my screen. First, welcome. We're going to be talking about what your superpowers are and how you could better utilize them to reach your professional and personal goals, how you could see how it could be used to reach your financial goals, be used better in your business so you could see more of the success you want to see and accomplishing your goals. So I'm going to be running you guys through a quick presentation. It's not going to take too long. Both of you guys who are attending live here, I have already took the flight assessment and booked an execution call with me. For everyone else who's watching this who hasn't already booked their flight assessment or execution call with me, I highly recommend you do so, so you know in particular what your superpowers are and specifically how you could use them to accomplish your goals, how you can utilize them better to accomplish more of your goals and see more of the success you want to see. And also understand with every superpower, with every gift, there is limitations and there is gaps that can be holding you back, that you could be limiting yourself. So just bringing some awareness to what some of your limitations are from the overuse or the misuse of your superpower and how they could hold you back. If you want that specifically for you and you haven't already, we'll book a flight assessment and an execution call with me and we'll go over that. For you two guys here live who've already booked your flight assessment and execution call and already have some awareness as far as your superpower and limitation, is we're going to be addressing what other people's superpowers might be. And by understanding what other people's superpowers might be, you're going to, and how they think and what motivates them and what drives their decision making, you're going to understand how to communicate to them differently, right? Because only 30% of people are flight attendants. Only 30% of people are grounds crew. Only 28% of people are air traffic control. And only 12% of people are pilots, right? So understanding that people think different, the way they make decisions are different, the way they like to communicate is different. And so understanding that is going to allow you to improve your communication in your relationships and with employees, with coworkers, with bosses, with people you're talking to, with clients. It's going to allow you to better communicate and overall have a better relationship because you understand people aren't wired the same way you're wired, right? So that's the value for you guys here today. And for everyone watching this that hasn't already booked their flight assessment execution call, make sure you do so, so you can find out what your superpowers are and how specifically you could utilize them to reach your goals. So with that being said, I'm going to share my screen with you. Let's get right into it. So, 1 second. Got a lot of tabs open. We're going to go into it. So, as you guys probably already knew, I got certified as an extreme execution coach. 1 second, I gotta. So, let me share my screen real quick. I got certified as an extreme execution coach. Right. So I'm certified. Can you guys see that or no? You guys can see that? Yep. All right. So as you guys know, I got certified as an extreme execution coach by Eric Thomas, the greatest motivational speaker in the world, arguably one of the greatest of all time. He's right up there with Tony Robbins, Les Brown, and other great speakers. So I'm a certified extreme execution coach by him. And that's what this presentation, what this video is about the extreme execution certification and the flight assessment and how you can utilize it to see your superpowers, right? So we'll go straight into it. So obviously this is Eric Thomas. This is who I'm certified as an extreme execution coach by. This is a quote by him, pain is temporary, quitting lasts forever. You know, Eric Thomas motivation, right? So that's a picture I just got of him. He has a PhD. This is where this flight assessment comes from, is from him. It was actually created originally from somebody else in 1928 by some super smart psychologists, people obsessed with human behavior. He took it and simplified it and made it related to the flight experience. So that's why it's called the flight assessment, is so it's related to your experience if you guys have ever been on a plane before, it's related to your experience on a plane. There's a pilot, there's a grounds crew, there's a flight attendant, there's air traffic control, right? And this is just the picture of me with Eric Thomas, right? I got certified as an extreme execution coach with him just about 2 weeks ago. All right. So next, the reason it's called the flight assessment is because it's related to your flight experience. Like I just mentioned, Eric Thomas basically got a lot of value from this assessment, but realized because it was made by psychologists and scientists, they use very advanced terminology that not everyone could easily comprehend and apply to their professional and personal goals, to their overall life. So he related it to the flight experience, gave the assessment symbols so people could better comprehend what exactly is the assessment saying. So that's what gave birth to the flight assessment, is symbolizing it with the flight experience. Now, the basis of the flight assessment is, again, flight attendant, grounds crew, air traffic control, and pilot. And these measure four different things. So the flight attendant measures your interactiveness, your tendencies and preferences when it comes to interacting and influencing others. The grounds crew represents the way you like to go about working in any given environment. You might like to work fast, you might like to work slow, right? So the assessment measures how you like to go about the pace you like to work at. Number three is cautiousness. Now, this is symbolized as the air traffic controller. As you can imagine, they're the people up in the towers, making sure that planes take off and land safely and don't crash into each other in the middle of the sky, right? So that symbolizes the air traffic control, right? And this is measures your tendencies and preferences when it comes to following rules, procedures, and protocols given by other people. So that is the air traffic controller. And now the last one is the pilot, the one that is the head of the plane, right? You can imagine he's straight going straight for business. He's all about solving problems, right? He goes to the head of the plane, grabs the steering wheel, and his job, his focus is to take you from point A to point B, right? So point A to point B. And this measures your tendencies and preferences when it comes to making decisions and solving problems, right? That is symbolized as the pilot, right? So all of us have all four of these in us, right? But God has created us with one or two specific ones that we are higher in, where we have specific superpowers with, right? And so we'll go into that. And obviously, again, if you guys have watched it, or if you guys have already booked your flight assessment and your execution call with me, you probably already have a good idea of what your superpower is and how you can utilize it to reach your goals. Now, if you guys are watching this and you haven't booked your flight assessment or execution call with me, make sure you do so, so you can identify specifically which ones are yours and how you can better utilize them to reach your goals. All right. So this is an example of somebody's results in the flight assessment, right? This is an example. Right. And we're going to go over one by one, but based off this assessment, we can see the natural state and the adaptive state. So the natural state is the colored bars, the adaptive state is the gray bars, right? So this is how you might adapt in different circumstances or situations, in any given environment. Maybe there's a stress in the environment. Maybe your natural state isn't getting you the results you want. The person might adapt in the specific way, either plus or minus, and that's what the gray bars represent. The solid bars represent your natural state, right? Like how you are, laid back, chillax, no special circumstance or situation, right? That's how you naturally are. Now, based off this person's assessment, obviously the highest one is this person's unique superpower, right? So air traffic controller, right? And then the second highest one is the pilot. Now, what does this mean? Is the person's superpower, how God has created them, their natural tendencies and preferences, they have a strength when it comes to the air traffic controller, right? And so what, and then the second one is the pilot. The pilot is their second highest one. So in this person's assessment, I would bring awareness to their air traffic controller and also their pilot when it comes to their strengths, and also making them conscious of their limitations. Obviously, I do this with all four of them, but we focus in on those two, the air traffic controller and the pilot, to clarify what their superpowers are and how they could better utilize it to reach their goals. Now, the flight attendant, this person is a high flight attendant, right? But their superpower, if you scored, even anything really above a 60, is really going to be a high flight attendant. And remember, only 30% of people are high flight attendants. This is a superpower, a strength that is about expressing oneself, being optimistic, being extroverted, being energetic. This is the life of the party. This is your Will Smith. These are the famous entertainers, right? Even E.T. is a high flight attendant. Eric Thomas is a high flight attendant, right? So these are people that love to talk to people. They're relationship-based people. They're driven by why, right? And they're driven by relationships. So specifically, if you're a high flight attendant, you have the superpower of expression, of optimism, of being energetic, of being extroverted if you're a high flight attendant. And again, only 30% of people, 3 out of 10, 30 out of 100 are high flight attendants. Now, grounds crew, this is the measure of your pace, the pace that you like to work at. The flight attendant measures people. The grounds crew measures your pace, how fast you like to work. Are you super fast-paced and urgent, or are you more patient, thoughtful, methodical in the way that you move, right? This measures how fast you like to work. So this person, you know, what style is a 10, similar to myself, very fast-paced, urgent, even sometimes impatient, because that's how fast they like to move, right? Now, if you scored high in this style, and this was your superpower, right? In a grounds crew, your superpower is that you are more patient, thoughtful, slower, right? You're more methodical in the way that you move, right? This person is less likely to make mistakes because they're thinking through things, they're moving methodically, right? And the higher the style is, this person also represents the grounds crew, which you guys can imagine when you're flying when you're on an airplane, right? You guys have been on an airplane before, right? So if you haven't, right, this is how it works. You've been on a plane, right? If you're on a plane, there's people beneath the plane before you take off that are loading your luggage. They're loading your bags, right? They fill up the gas tank. They load up the snacks for the flight attendants to give to you, the passenger, right? They also guide the pilot on and off the airway. They do lots of different jobs. So these people are very flexible. That's a superpower of theirs. They can do many different tasks. Their superpowers, they're very flexible. Now, these people are driven by how, so they like to understand the process of how things work, right? They're very flexible. They're people-based people. They're process people. So they like to serve people through actions and through processes. They like to do many different tasks for people. And that's their superpower, right? They're flexible, methodical, patient, great listeners. That's the high grounds crew, right? Very different from the high flight attendant, right? The flight attendants are people as well. But they're more driven by expression, right? Talking, interacting with people, right? The grounds crew, as you score high in a grounds crew, it not only measures how fast you like to work, because if you're high, you're more slower, more patient, more methodical, but it also measures the how you like to help people. You help people through many different things. You have a flexibility to do many different tasks. So these people are also driven by more how, like how do things work? The flight attendants are more driven by why. Why am I doing this? Why should I talk to this person? They're more driven by why, and they're driven by relationships. Grounds crew are driven more by relationships, but it's more through how. It's more through processes. Make sense? Now, the high air traffic control, these are goal-oriented people, task-oriented people. They like to accomplish goals, right? But when it comes to a high air traffic controller, this person, think about the symbol, the story of an air traffic controller. They're up in the towers. They have arguably the most important job. They're making sure planes don't crash into each other up in the sky. They're making sure airplanes take off and land safely, right? So the high air traffic controller has to be very systematic, very analytical, very, very perfectionist driven, because they can't make mistakes. Think about the story, the example. They can't make mistakes. They have to do everything perfectly. So these people, their strength, their superpower, people who have a high style in air traffic control, a superpower in air traffic control, is that they strive for perfection. They want to do things the right way versus fast. They want to do it the right way, right? They do things systematically. They follow rules and procedures and protocols to a T. They don't mess up, right? They follow it to a T. So that's the air traffic controller's superpower. Now, pilots, right? Again, air traffic controllers are only 28% in the population. Only 28% of people are as perfectionists, as good at following systems and rules as an air traffic controller. Only 28%, 28 out of 100 are as good at doing that. So that's why it's a superpower and it's a strength. Now, pilots, there's only 12% of people are high pilots. Think about the example, the story. Pilots go straight to the head of the plane. They grab the steering wheel. They're locked in. They're focused from taking you from point A to point B, right? Only 12% of people are high pilots. 1 out of 10, 12 out of 100, right? And so these people's superpower and what they're really good at is knowing what they want and how to get it. Think about a pilot, right? They know where they're going, where they're flying. They're flying to Dallas. They're flying to Houston. They're flying to Los Angeles. They're flying to Atlanta. They're flying to New York, whatever. They know where they're going and they know how to fly the plane. They know what they want and where they're going, right? And how to get it. That's their superpower and their strength. That's not everyone's. Some people will have trouble with that. So that's a superpower of a pilot. Pilots are very they're competitive and they're ambitious and they're determined, right? So these are more goal-oriented people. They strive to accomplish tasks and they strive to accomplish goals. These people are what-driven people. They just care about what's the problem, what's the goal, what's going on, right? They're very like want to get doing something, right? So when you're speaking to a pilot, you have to talk about what. When you're speaking to an air traffic controller, they're more driven by how, because they're process-based people. When you're speaking to a grounds crew, they're process-based people too. So you got to communicate how does it work. When you're communicating to a flight attendant, you got to communicate why is this important, right? Why is this video or this training for you guys important? It's because it's going to help you better understand your superpowers and how you can utilize them better, and also understand what other people's superpowers are and how they are different and they have different gifts, right? And so that's why this is important. When you communicate to flight attendants or high flight attendants, you want to communicate why. Grounds crew and air traffic control, you want to communicate how. When you're speaking to a pilot, somebody that's determined, competitive, ambitious, you want to communicate what's the goal, what's the problem, what we're doing, right? And so that's why it's important to understand not only your superpowers and your gifts and some of the limitations that might come from the overuse or the misuse of your gift and superpower, but understand other people and what their gifts and their superpowers are and how they like to think and how they like to communicate, right? Because then it's going to allow you to coach them better, sell them better. It's going to allow you to have a better relationship with them, right? Cool. Now, this is for the people who are watching. Both of you guys are actually both on my Extreme Execution Program. So this is what you're going to be experienced through the next 6 months of working with me is getting, I mean, there's much more that goes into the program than what's listed here, but it's getting really good at your superpowers and making sure you are not holding yourself back at all from the overuse or the misuse of your superpower. Now, for all of the guys watching the recording or, you know, watching this video or listening, is that if you want to know what your superpowers are, are you Spider-Man? Are you Superman? Are you Batman? Are you Flash? Right? Who are you? You want to know what your unique superpowers are and how you could better utilize them to maximize your results in your business and your professional goals and your personal goals and your financial goals. If you want to understand that and you also want to understand what your limitations are and how you could limit those limitations so you don't hold yourself back, right? This, what you guys need to do is you need to book a flight assessment and execution call with me, right? So we can help, so I can personally help you get clarity and awareness of what your superpowers are, how you better utilize them to reach your goals, and also bring awareness to your limitations and how to kind of limit those limitations and avoid them, right? And have principles and systems in place so you don't no longer limit yourself. Then book a flight assessment and execution call with me. You can message me at Devin Kripe on Facebook or Instagram. You guys have me, or you guys can also email me at Devin Kripe gmail.com to book your flight assessment and your execution call with me. With that being said, guys, you see that right there. The flight assessment, again, is represented as the plane and your flight experience and your superpowers. We're using Superman, but it could be Batman. It could be Spider-Man. It could be Flash. It could be Zoom, or whatever superheroes, Captain America, Thor, right? Whatever your superpowers are, you could, whatever your favorite superhuman is, or superhero. Yeah. Whatever your favorite superhero is, it could be your representation, but all of us have superpowers, right? So better understanding and having awareness of what those superpowers are and how you could better utilize them to reach your goals is extremely important. Awareness is like 50% of the game. And then also having awareness of what the overuse and the misuse of your superpowers are. So definitely look at booking a flight assessment and execution call with me. For you guys here attending live, there's a lot of value. ET, Eric Thomas, gives a lot of credit to the success in his marriage, being married for 35 years, right? And making multi-millions a year from speaking, making $100,000 to $400,000 a speech, gives a lot of credit to this assessment, to the flight assessment, right? Gives a lot of credit, not only to the flight assessment that I've given you guys, but also what I'm certified in as an execution coach on having you apply it and execute it in your goals, in the pursuit of your goals. So I would just ramp up your serious level within the execution program and how you're going to better utilize this assessment and the execution coaching to reach your dreams, your purpose, your financial goals, your personal goals, your fitness goals, whatever it is that you want to accomplish. I would just treat it more seriously and definitely be excited, because you have superpowers and those superpowers can get you whatever you want in this life. So with that being said, guys, do you have any last questions before we hop off this live today? That's the presentation. Do you guys have any questions as far as what we went over today? Rashawn, Daniel, if not, you guys are both on the execution program. So you could just message me, right? And I'll get back to you as soon as possible. And then also we can talk about it on your next one-on-one execution call, or you can drop your questions in the community and we could talk about it on the next group call, the next execution group call. Rashawn, do you have a quick question, man?
I'm sure obviously as we progress, you'll go over it. But with the different, obviously being able to read behavioral systems and how people interpret things and different categories like that, is there certain wordplay or certain, obviously, it's expressive, it could be like behavior, actions as well, but like certain words or the way that they do things a certain way, or really just how they speak, like is speech, is that like plays a big impact included, as well as obviously with their actions, how they present themselves and how they act accordingly to certain situations will help give you clarity on what type of
there's a lot that goes into it, but as far as a quick point right now, Devin, Daniel, Rashawn, and anybody watching this, when it comes to communicating to these different types, right, different styles and preferences, is what you'll mainly notice, and that's what you want to keep in mind, right? Somebody who talks really fast like Devin is normally a high pilot, and high flight attendants are typically people who speak really fast, right? Daniel and many other people watching this, if you speak more slowly and more methodical or more analytical, or have to say the right thing, I want to say the right thing, I have to be a perfectionist in the way that I speak, they're probably going to speak a little bit slower, right? So that's one huge tip, is if you're speaking to somebody who really speaks fast, you're probably speaking to a pilot or a flight attendant. If you're talking to somebody who likes to be mellow and take his time in speaking and more slower in his tempo, you're probably speaking to somebody who's more high grounds crew and air traffic control, right? And that makes sense with what we went over today. Devin, Well, real briefly, I think it's a good recap for everyone as well. We'll go quick recap. Devin, I'll send you the recording if you want to go hear a little bit more in depth. But basically, I'm a certified extreme execution coach by Eric Thomas. Eric Thomas, arguably one of the greatest motivational speakers in the world. Just got certified by him 2 weeks ago. He's phenomenal, works for the NBA, NFL, Sprint. I'm pretty sure you know him, Dev. The flight assessment, this assessment has been around for over 100 years. It's used at top universities, the military, colleges, big corporations, Fortune 500 companies. Eric Thomas took the flight assessment, simplified it, gave it symbols, and that's why it's related to the flight experience. It's called the flight assessment. It has symbols that represent flight attendants, grounds crew, air traffic control, and pilot, trying to speak like a grounds crew, right? This measures 4 P's: people, pace, procedures, and problems. So that is the representation right there. We went over the 4 superpowers of a flight of the 4 different ones. So flight attendants, the life of the party. This is like your Will Smith, super extrovert, thrives off talking to people and relationships. They're just like the life of the party. They love speaking and talking. Grounds crew, very methodical, patient, flexible. They can do many different things. They care about people, but it's more in an introverted way. They have superpowers of great listeners, doing lots of great things for people through processes. They're great people. They're great, like a supporting cast. Air traffic control are perfectionists. They got to do things the right way and perfect, right? They're very analytical and systematic. Accountants, right? People who are air traffic controllers, people who have to do things perfectly. Normally, this is like a perfect place for them. A successful air traffic control, by the way, is like a Warren Buffett. Is like a successful air traffic controller. All right. And pilots, this is like a Michael Jordan, right? These are people that are very ambitious, determined, committed. They know what they want and they typically know how to get it very easily, better than majority of people. So that's their superpower. So it's not only important to know what your superpower is and how to better utilize it to maximize your results and reach your professional and personal goals, but it's also valuable to understand what you're not and what other people's superpowers are and how you can bring them on your team to reach your goals. And also when you're communicating to somebody, realizing that not everyone's a pilot, not everyone's an air traffic control, not everyone's a flight attendant, not everyone's a grounds crew, and understanding how they're different, right? And so if you, Devin, I know we already talked, if you want to book your flight assessment or you want to book an execution call with me, completely free, just DM me at Facebook or Instagram, or email me at devinkripe.com, or message me on Facebook or Instagram at Devin Kripe, or message my number if you have it. And that's how we can book your flight assessment and your execution call. The flight assessment costs $200. If you're going to get it on Eric Thomas' website, I can give it to you for free. If you're serious, and we can book a 30-minute consultation to go over your results and how you can better utilize your superpowers to reach your goals and also bring some awareness to your limitations so you don't hold yourself back in any type of way. Yeah, cool, guys. Is that it? Any other questions? If not, we'll get rocking and rolling.
Yeah, Micah, just a quick little pointer real quick too. So what was the 4 for the areas? Is I know flight attendants, people.
And also keep in mind, all four of these, all of you guys have them. So what this assessment measures is 4 P's, right? It measures people, which is the flight attendant, pace, which is the grounds crew, procedures, that's the air traffic controller, and problems, that's the pilot. So 4 P's. And everyone has those 4 P's. It just, those are the 4 things it measures. It measures how you interact with people, what type of pace you like to work at, how you go about following rules and procedures, and how you go about solving problems. That's what this assessment measures. It's a high level leadership, communication, and personality assessment.
Yeah, and then the last quick note was when it comes to, obviously, I guess it's kind of up in the air because it depends on, you know, what type of field of work you're doing or what exactly, you're trying to pursue. But, like, is there, like, a balance between the type of people that you – or the type of, between the 4 that you need in your circle? Of course, you know, you probably want at least one of each. Or, like, would you need to weigh, you know, more on – for example, you know, you might have more flight attendants and, you know, like air traffic controllers because they kind of go together. or I guess that kind of just determined or
it really depends on what you're doing. Yeah, it really depends on what your goals are and what you're trying to pursue. And like a business model, for example, right? Think about it. I mean, the plane is a good representation. So typically, like, let's say you're, if you're a high pilot, you're probably an entrepreneur, right? So, or a natural born leader, a pilot, right? Boom. You probably want at least one of each. You want an air traffic controller to help you have the right systems and do things the right way and be analytical. You want a grounds crew who's like the supporting cast and does a lot of different things for you, is very patient, methodical. They're very flexible. They can run a whole bunch of things for you. And then a flight attendant who's like super extroverted and thrives off talking to people. This would be like a great person in sales, customer service, you know, just interacting with people all the time. So like, I mean, having one in each would be valuable. Like if you're a high pilot, you probably don't need another high pilot. You're probably going to butt heads a lot. You can't have two pilots flying the plane at the same time. You can have a co-pilot, but having two, like that wouldn't be your first team member or partnership or, you know, hire, right? You probably want to hire the other ones that you're not, right? They're missing pieces because you need all four of these to run fly a plane, right? You need all four of these. So in a business model, that's what you need. And pretty much anything in a basketball team, you need all three of these. In a relationship, you guys also want to understand how you guys are different. Like this is very valuable for me and my girlfriend because we're both high pilots, right? So understanding who you're with will be tremendous in your marriage and your relationships. Also understanding who your mother is, understanding who your brother is. Like this assessment is valuable. If you guys, I talk to a lot of real estate agents. If you understand what your client is, it's going to allow you, like even from a coaching perspective, knowing what my clients are, I'm better able to coach them. From a real estate, it's very similar. If you're a real estate agent and you're talking to, you know, your clients, you're not going to butt heads as much because you're going to know that they're air traffic controller. So they're going to be perfectionists. They want to do things slowly because they want to do it right. You're going to understand. So it works for so many different things in your relationships, your personal friendships, in your business. It's extremely valuable for sure for everything like that. Cool. Any other questions, guys? All right. So you can message me, you too, Dev. Let's book your execution call to go over your superpowers and your limitations. And I'm certified in this assessment. I know it's great to already have the assessment, but if there's a lot of tremendous value I can provide and give you some different insights as far as the assessment. For you two guys who are on my Extreme Execution Program, we're going to start group calls in the next week or two, right? Let's book your next one-on-one in the next week or so. Continue to crush your fitness and health goals as well. Crush your workouts, crush your macros and everything like that. For all of you guys watching this live, the recording, right? If you guys want to find out what your superpowers are and how you can better utilize them to reach your professional, personal, and financial goals, make sure you book your flight assessment and your execution call with me, and I can help you better understand what your superpowers are, also bringing awareness to the overuse and the misuse of them and how those things can limit you and how to better limit those limitations so you don't hold yourself back or shoot yourself in the foot, right? And you can continue to see faster, better, and easier results, knowing your superpower and what your limitations are with those superpowers. Because every single superpower has kryptonite. That's how I want you to think about it. All right, guys. Appreciate you being here. Yeah, I'll see you guys soon. All right. God bless. Have a wonderful day. And I'll see you soon.
All right. Appreciate you, man. I was going to ask you a quick question.
Yeah, what's up, Dev?
So as far as, well, you said you're a high pilot, right? Are you also...
I'm a high pilot, also... No brakes.
No air traffic. Yeah, my shoot day. It's crazy you are, so I'm meeting too. Being the, what did you say? Was it 3% of people are pilots? Or 10%? 12. Yeah, so 12% of people, in the world are pilots. So that's awesome. My question is, when did you take the flight assessment the first time, and then have you took it recently?
Yeah, so first answer your question. I took 1.0 probably a year and a half ago, and then I just took the 2.0 probably a month before I got certified, so six or 7 weeks ago. Based off what I, you know, getting certified, they say that you only want to take this assessment once a year, typically. Because you won't see drastic changes more than within a year, closer than a year. You might see them in a year, really depends. Or these your styles could drastically change if you just went through some tragedy or crazy life circumstance, like you just had a kid, you just moved to Africa, you just started a new business or started a new job that's completely different than anything you've ever done. Somebody just died in your family, you just got divorced. Like these big life changes could change your natural style and mm-hmm. who you are. That's when you would, you know, you could take another assessment if that's the case with you. Just let me know.
Well, yeah, the reason I asked that, because I noticed that I took it a while back as well, and it was different.
Okay.
So I, you know, was more of a high eye, but also I think it was more ground screw. But then I started the business and having to be a lot quicker on my feet and make a certain decision. But I gradually kind of got to that pilot. But naturally, I feel like I'm more of a flight attendant ground screw, but the business forced me, you know, to be more pilot. So.
Absolutely. Absolutely, man. Well, let me know. You could just send me your assessment, or if you think they might be different, we can take a new one. Either way, and then we'll book your execution call. All right.
Yep. Well, sounds good. Do you have like Calendly or?
Yeah. Well, you have my number. We can just book it in manually.
Okay.
Yeah, for sure, man. Cool, guys. Appreciate all of you being here. Appreciate all of your time. Appreciate everyone who's watching this recording. Make sure you message me at Devin Kripe on Facebook or Instagram, or devinkripe@gmail.com. Either way, get a hold of me if you want to book your flight assessment and your execution call. Other than that, God bless. Have a wonderful rest of the day, rest of the week, whenever you're watching this. And I'll talk to you guys soon, each one of you. God bless.
God bless you, brother. Have a good night or day.
Bye.